Labą dieną. Today I'm gonna be finishing a couple of my, so to speak, iconic lamps. So I thought it's a great opportunity to talk about these because they are very much different. First of all, the styles are different because this one will have a bulb over here and this one will be lit from underneath. Secondly, these are made from completely different materials. So I used an apple tree and casted it into epoxy for this one. And I took a piece of alder and filled it with polyester resin for this one. I made the pieces like 5 years ago and now it's very easy to tell how differently the resins age. So polyester haven't changed a bit. It's as clear as it was in the beginning. The epoxy on the other hand have yellowed a bit. It's not much, it doesn't look too terrible, but when you put the pieces together, the difference is very much evident. And one more difference is that these resins create different formations inside the casting once overheated. And just to make it clear, I was looking for those side effects of overheated reaction like bubbles and cracks, because I think it looks charming and very artistic. Anyway, each of the resin comes with its own character, so epoxy bubbles more while polyester shatters more, but each of them looks really stunning. Next step is to spray some lacquer onto these pieces, and yeah, polishing is also an option, but it's very time consuming. So these are sanded to 1000 grit, and once I will apply a coat of varnish, it will bring the full transparency and glossiness to the pieces. So let's do this. So while the lacquer is setting, I will start working on the base for this casting. So I have my drawing here and you don't really have to understand everything. Basically, it's gonna be a simple box with continuous grain going all around it, so it would look neat. And inside I'm gonna add this lighting unit. So let's get to it. So I've created this profile to accept 6mm plywood, and all that's left to do is miter the stick and shape it into the box. But I would like to pause on this one and insert a couple of magnets into the bottom of this casting and spray lacquer it, so while the lacquer sets, I could continue working on the base. So yeah, let's install those magnets. casing is prepared. This time I made sure to use the masking tape trick to prevent any glue squeeze out onto the bottom, and it came out perfect. I noticed a few open bubbles, but I don't really care about these because the casting will be facing down into the base and no dust gonna go in there, so it's not a problem. Well, anyway, let's spray some varnish. So, back to making the base. So I decided to first of all chop the stick into side pieces and miter those afterwards. But once I made the first cut, I realized that this one's too short. And that means that this one is also too short. So yeah, I will have to remake this one. Let's go! Making zero clearance setup always pays off, not only for reduced chip out, but also for accuracy. So I just have to meet this corner with already cut line, and I can be certain that I'm gonna nail it. I have to let the glue set, and it's already quite late, so I guess I'm gonna be finishing this base tomorrow. Though I can finish the polyester lamp because it doesn't have any base and I have all the components. So let's put it together. You know, I don't really like that the bulb socket doesn't match the color of the wire. So I guess I'm gonna hit it with white paint real quick, and then I will put everything together. So this one's done. I'm really glad I painted this socket because it contrasts with the wood so nicely. Well, anyway, sincerely thank you for being with me today, and I hope to see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.